The 2018 FISU World University Beach Volleyball Championship is set in a special place, Munich Olympia Park, a scene of the 1972 Olympic Games. The sporting nature of the event was largely overshadowed by the Munich Massacre, in which 11 Israeli athletes and coaches and a West German police officer were killed by Black September Palestinian terrorists. We spoke with Till Luft, former runner and general secretary of the European Athletics Association, and Heinrich Thade, former modern pentathlete, about their memories of the events.
I've been there. We woke up early in the morning, sirens were howling, and police were all over the place. And then the news spread that Arab terrorists had invaded the Israeli compound. And immediately the games were stopped, and the Connolly Street, where it happened, was blocked. And we could see snipers on the roofs, and there were negotiations. And eventually, we saw that the terrorists and their hostages were driven away to Fürstenfeldbruck.
I realized the next morning when I woke up what happened. And I was sitting the whole day in front of television watching the unfortunate event and the tries to rescue them. I'm sure there were mistakes made, but that's another story. That's a political story. And I watch on TV the famous words by Avery Brundage, the IOC president: the games must go on, which in a way I agree with, because you should not give up against terrorists. So in that way, I think it was the right words.
The mood was very somber. Everything was, everybody was depressed. And then there was the speech of Avery Brundage with the focus on the words, "the games must go on." And I think it was the right thing. You cannot succumb to terrorists when the games and something good is at stake. The atmosphere was very somber. Everybody was subdued. But then again, there was a feeling of resilience. We wouldn't give in. We would carry on, and the games would survive, and the terrorists hopefully not.
But then the final days, I returned back to here. The final days had not the same light spirit which they had before. That was part of it, and the whole Olympiad was prolonged for another day. And it might be symbolic, but on the last day it rained, you know, and the weather became bad, opposite to what it was before. I'm quite glad that now we have two places to remember the attack here, stone and this more complex memorial, which tells the youth what happened in this park. Well, it happened in the village actually, and at the airport. But
with the new events, the atmosphere is different. It's more hilarious. It's more public orientated. In former days, it was sportsman and performance orientated. Nowadays, sports events are more for the public to take part. You know, you would clap in former times when you were watching, but now you get taken in, and that's a good thing. I saw some matches, yes, and I'm very proud of what is happening here. It's my colleagues who have organized it. I'm very impressed by the way they perform.
Oh, that's great. I had the honor and privilege to organize here European Championships in 30 years after 72. So in 2002, we had the German Championships here, and we used part of the village as athletes' village. And at that time, we brought back a little bit the spirit of the whole thing. And now, again, with this event, you have the spirit of youth coming together and of joyful games. And so I'm very happy that the park is still filled with sport. Besides competition sports, this park also provides for the people here for leisure time and for running, jogging, for cycling. So this park is a great legacy of the Olympics 72. Beach volleyball is a trendy sport, is a very youth sport, and it's not my sport, I'm too small. I was a runner, but still, I like this kind of sport and this spirit which is here.